Imagine you're in a room and a smoke alarm goes off, smoke is pouring out from under the door, and if you don't leave that room quickly, a fire could erupt and you could be suffocated or burned to death. It's obvious what you do. But now again, what happens if you're in that same room and there are 10 other people and all of them do nothing?
Our first participant is Mary Mizuno, a London student who thinks she's arrived early. What she doesn't know is that behind this door, there's about to be a serious fire in the hotel kitchen. Or at least the illusion of one, created by a smoke machine and some sound effects. What will she do?
Ah, she's now noticed the smoke and is concerned. At this point, she decides to investigate to find out what's going on. She's immediately taken responsibility for figuring out what to do.
Mary does the sensible thing and evacuates quickly. But Mary was on her own. This time, we've planted 7 actors who are all in on the experiment. We've said to them, when you see the smoke, do nothing. Our second participant is Lauren Heffernan, also a student. What will she do? Now, how long before she dashes out of the room?
She's checking increasingly to see what the other people are thinking. But who can she appeal to? The answer is nobody. She turns to the norm of the group. Ignore the smoke.
I was looking for some sort of reaction from someone else, even just the slightest little thing, that they'd recognize that there was something, you know, going on here. For me to kind of react on that and then do something about it, I kind of needed prodding.
She's waiting for someone else to react. Why isn't anyone else reacting? She feels uncomfortable. She doesn't want to embarrass herself by taking the lead, taking action. But something is definitely wrong.
Lauren stayed in the room for 20 minutes after spotting the smoke, concerned but immobile. The fire brigade say that if this fire had been real, even if flames hadn't burned through the door, she would have died of asphyxiation in this time. In the end, we had to ask her to leave.
What about him? I was surprised that I didn't do anything at all. I was just literally waiting. I just thought that someone else is surely going to say something soon. And because no one else did, I just didn't react at all.
We tried the experiment 10 times, and the same thing happened over and over again. If the person was on their own, they left quickly. If they were in a group of 3 or more, they stayed, rooted to the spot. The average length of time they stayed, 13 minutes. In real fires, people die because of behavior like this. Only one person in our experiment didn't go along with the crowd behavior. Artist James McKechnie.
What's that coming up from under the table? Is it fire?
I don't know.
Wait till she comes back.
Yeah. Yeah. She said just to wait here,
yeah.
Didn't she?
What? What's that?
What is that? I don't know. She said just to wait here, didn't she? She's coming right down now.
James isn't going to sit in a dangerous room just because everyone else does. Yeah. Or is he? The power of the group proves irresistible.
The reassurances of the rest of the group that somebody else is responsible seemed to be sufficient to pull him back into place. Instead of leaving the room and calling for help, he sits back down again and waits. Now everybody's looking at the smoke, but in some ways that gives the group even more influence. After all, if everybody can see the smoke and no one's panicking, well, It would be crazy for him to do it too.
James stays in the room for another 10 minutes before finally leaving. In a real fire, he'd have been unconscious and close to suffocation.